The CS did not deliver the message in person, but his statement could not have been grimmer, confirming the worst on the Kenyan national, who had arrived in the country on 13th March from South Africa via Swaziland. The statement said in part, the 66-year-old Kenyan who passed on this afternoon had been admitted at the Aga Khan Hospital Intensive Care Unit. The CS adding what seems to be a common factor in most of the COVID-19 deaths worldwide, pre-existing conditions. He was suffering from diabetes. The CS did not identify the deceased, but Citizen TV has learned that the man was a prominent engineer working with a regional firm and was a frequent traveler. He was admitted to the hospital last Sunday after he fell ill before being diagnosed with COVID-19. The death has raised the stakes in the fight against the disease as the number of cases in the country continue to climb.
We have received confirmation of 3 people who have tested positive for coronavirus disease. This brings the total number of confirmed COVID-19 cases in Kenya to 31.
The government signaling that particular counties were beginning to emerge as hotspots. Among them are the coastal counties of Mombasa, Kwale and Kilifi, where Deputy Governor Gideon Saburi tested positive for COVID-19 and remains in isolation undergoing treatment. More cases from Kilifi are known because of the government's policy of keeping identities secret. Nairobi County leads in the park, having received the highest number of import cases. Kajiado County has also been listed as a high-risk area, with the first patient said to have been to Rongai, with the possibility of multiple contacts. Parts of the government's measures to upscale the fight against the virus in hotspot areas include an increase in surveillance. Extra personnel have been deployed, with the government said to carry out more sensitization to the public. The government also bolstering contact tracing in a bid to reduce further spread of the virus. More isolation centers have also been identified in the high-risk areas.
I therefore urge people at the coast and Kilifi counties in particular to observe social distancing with self-determination.
Kilifi Governor Amason Kingi, who is under self-quarantine for coming into contact with his deputy, has closed over 20 farms in the county in a bid to curb the spread. Kingi shutting down all economic processing zones, Mombasa cement factory, Mabati rolling mills, all salt processing farms, all sand harvesting quarries, all coral blocks cutting quarries, all manganese quarries, all ballast quarries and other industries within the county. As of today, 1,029 people have contacted positive patients, with 123 already discharged, with health teams still monitoring 906 people. With Kenya now reporting a total of 31 COVID-19 cases, the Ministry of Health warned Kenyans to adhere to the protocols issued to keep the virus at bay, or better, break the transmission chain. Stephen Letos, Citizen TV, Nairobi.